We're going to look at the latest issue of Video Fashion Monthly, a brand new way to look at fashion without turning a page. It's a fashion magazine brought to life on video. This month, you have a front row seat at the fall 1983 New York collections. Let's take a look at what's coming up. Video Fashion Monthly has all the best from the New York designers, including the major fall fashion trends. Bob Mackie, designer to the stars. An exciting look at fashion's new themes for the season. A photojournalist's view of Norma Kamali, street fashion's hottest designer. Beauty backstage at Oscar de la Renta, featuring the newest haircut for autumn. Costume jewelry makes a comeback. Must buys, sure sellers everyone will want. A retrospective of Mary Mcfadden, designer and artist. Now sit back and take your front row seat at the New York Collections, fall 1983. This fall, New York's top designers took all-American sportswear and dressed it up to create a brand new style. One that's dressy and pulled together for day. And casually dazzling for evening. And now, the first New York trend, silhouettes on parade. All kinds, all strong, all dramatic. The colors divide into two themes, stark black, white, and gray, and sparkling jewel tones. Fall fabrics are deluxe sportswear classics for day and sparkling fireworks for evening. From Hollywood to you. Now you can buy a Bob Mackie. You don't have to be Cher or Ann Margaret. Bob chats with us today about his life in Hollywood and his new work on 7th Avenue.
I don't think of myself as a Hollywood designer. I think of myself as an American designer. And not a New York, not a Hollywood, not anything. I mean, I try to think about the whole country. Well, for the last 20 years, I've dressed lots of wonderful people, and I'm still dressing a lot of them. So it's we had a nice relationship. The list is long, but it's been very rewarding for me.
Is there one particular project, maybe for a performer, that was really an extraordinary project to undertake that you recall?
Well, actually, the 11 years I did Carol Burnett and dressed her, you know, as bag ladies and socialites and anything you want to mention. I mean, I dressed her in all those different costumes. Wonderful. I had the best time making comments on society and different stratas of life. I like to think of what's happening right now, what people are wanting. That's very important. Otherwise, you're making a lot of clothes that nobody wants. But I think women like to get dressed up and look gorgeous, and look sexy maybe, glamorous, turn a few heads. Well, I've used a lot of jewel tones, a lot of rich colors paired with black. I think it's a good way to look, and everything sort of goes together and mixes and matches, although, you know, that's not a sportswear line, but I think it's nice when everything kind of goes with everything else.
Classic to Bob Mackie. Can you define a classic?
A classic? Well, I suppose if anybody thinks of a classic Bob Mackie, they think of a glamorous evening gown with swathed in furs and glitter and diamonds and all that sort of thing. You know, that's old-time classic Bob Mackie. I'm hoping to build some new classics. I'm working on it. I really don't have a favorite piece. It's hard, you know, you love them all for different reasons, like children. But I suppose maybe the unicorn gown at the end was fun because it was kind of a surprise.
The three biggest looks for the season: casual dazzle, man about town, sweater dressing. The newest ways to look around the clock. You can be casual and simply dazzling in these designs. Thank you. The surprise influence in city sportswear is the man about town look. What a blend of comfort and fashion. The sweater dress. Norma Kamali, the hottest name in fashion on the street and on the avenue. Her clothes speak for themselves.
Yes, now can you just
catch Norma Kamali's great young fashion in a photo session for British Vogue, where the clothes live and work best on the street.
Covering the collections. Right, the ready-to-wear collections, and I've been doing it for quite a few years now, and that's about it.
And you're doing something special for Norma Kamali, because this
right.
is a runway show.
No, but we always do that. I mean, we always take pictures, we take garments out, take a few pictures of Norma Kamali, because she doesn't do a show. Mm-hmm. And so it was exciting to do it on tape this time.
Just a sec. Okay, go. All right, again, let's do it again. And the hand, yes, right. Just tight, just a minute, tight. Don't move, that's it.
With every season, there are new beauty trends to finish off the look. This fall, makeup in soft colors and blunt haircuts.
What I did for the makeup in Oscar's show was we wanted something that is dramatic but yet classic, and something that would definitely show on the runway. because of the strong lights and also the photography. A lot of black and white photography is being done. And because of the colors that he used in the show, a lot of bright colors and also a lot of blacks, we wanted to have colors that would look good with all the changes. So we agreed on some colors, which is generally a smoky eye, like a deep charcoal. And we decided that for this show, we would use a little bit more color, so we brought in some very pretty violet tones, and we kept the lips a very classic soft red, not a bright yellow red, but a classic kind of cherry soft red. So if the girls were changing into bright greens or reds or blues, the color would go with all of that.
For Oscar de la Renta, he's doing, we're booked for the day, there's two shows, and we're doing just beautiful hair. You know, there's no, it can't be too wild. It just has to look beautiful and modern without being frumpy. Somebody like Diane, we just work with a haircut.
Did you do this haircut?
Yes, I did.
Tell me what you did.
Her hair is cut very blunt, and it's just fluff dried. And the only thing we play with is the bangs. She can wear them down or up like it is right here. It gives it a little more sophistication. They're just combed back and then sprayed a little bit, which I was getting ready to do a minute ago. And that way she can wear hats throughout the show. I just put a little spray right in the front like that. It's just combed back.
So you're a superb cutter, yes.
Thank you. But there's something about the way her hair hangs. It's just amazing cut like this. I mean, it attracts attention. I've gotten letters, people asking me, you know, I'm sure she has too.
You blow it dry, or does it just...
It's just fluffed, just with the hands. What do you do to it in the morning?
Naturally straight, my hair is, but it does have certain little cowlicks everywhere, like everyone's hair. So if there's a couple of places that need to be made more uniform, I do that with a little comb or something, and just a touch of the dryer. Otherwise, it can go very straight like this, naturally.
Well, whenever I work with Diane, I always like to do her hair, like, very simple. I know most people want to bend it under, or which can be done, and there's nothing wrong with that, but then it's not new anymore. This is what makes it look really new to me. Even on the runway, you see now a lot of girls sort of follow the trend now, but you see them, they look old-fashioned because it's done under, just like the old Sassoon haircut, which is old, it's from the 60s. This is a new version.
The accessory story for fall is the return of costume jewelry. Lots and lots of it. Thank you. Every season, there are certain items you can't do without. This fall, they are first, jackets and coats, second, sweater novelties, and third, the short evening dress. Buy matching jackets and coats that can be worn together or separately. Buy new sweater novelties for day and evening. Buy the new short evening dress. A great idea. Raised in the fashion and art world, Mary Mcfadden is a unique blend of designer and artist. Her distinctive trademarks include hand-painted silks, quilted jackets, and Mari pleated fabric, all strikingly original mosaics of color. Recipient of many awards, Mary Mcfadden won the prestigious Cody Award in 1976, the first year her company was incorporated. She won another Cody in 1978 and was elected to the Cody Hall of Fame in 1979.
It has been my aspiration from the very beginning to create women's clothes as an art form by the use of very beautifully hand-painted silks, by the cross-culture of textural qualities, and the very rare use and combination of colors. I've always had the saying, which I believe, that any beautiful dress is as good as any painting that's hanging in the Metropolitan today.
What do you, if you had to describe the Mary Mcfadden woman and what she looks like and how she feels in your clothes, how would you describe it?
The first thing I wanted to say is she loves the feel of the fabrics on her body, the feeling of non-construction and the feeling of complete movement of her body within these fabrics. And that, and in a sense, this gives her a certain security as she moves into a room to deal and to talk to people that she's going to spend the evening with or the day with.
My design philosophy has really emerged over the years. It's become certainly more refined. But as all designers start with an idea or a concept, they have to start somewhere before they enlarge their vision. And I suppose that my largest influence in the very beginning was the Ming Dynasty China and its color range. Mm-hmm. And then shortly after that, I suppose the jewels of Africa, the bones of them. I can't say that I'd say maybe that Celtic interlace and Byzantine mosaic would be the strongest design influence in our work today.
I'm curious about your fabric. You designed the fabric yourself, and where does it come from, and how does it end up looking that way? You do it all yourself, don't you?
Well, I have to explain the process to you. Originally, I have an idea, and I work with various technicians on this idea. Or I have a concept of a type of calligraphy and various color relationships. And the original painting is done on 8 mummy weight China silk. And so that the technique on this silk looks like a hand painting before it is screened for mass production.
This time we dedicated the collection to a theme which is really a spoof on Napoleon. It's called Napoleon at the Gates of New York. And the reason for doing a Napoleonic shell basically was to use the silhouettes of the Empire period, not only of the men, but of the women, in a modern fantasy.
Just experienced Video Fashion Monthly. In future issues, we'll be showing you the latest in fashion and beauty from all over the world.